Good morning. Myself, Sachin Deshmukh, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering of Walchand of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to learn about Pascal's law, and we are going to see the derivation of Pascal's law. At the end of this topic, you are able to calculate the intensity of pressure at any point in a liquid when it is at rest. This law was first initiated by French scientist Blaise Pascal. This law states that a fluid at rest in a closed container, a pressure change in one part is transmitted without loss to every portion of the liquid and to the wall of the container. Pascal also discovered that the pressure at a point in a fluid at rest is the same in all directions. The pressure would be the same in all planes passing through that specific point. Now we'll see the derivation. For this particular derivation, we have taken a very small wedge-shaped molecule so that we can find three axes on this x, y, and z axis. See here. Let us consider a very small wedge-shaped element BAC of a liquid as shown in the figure. This is a B, A, and C. This is a wedge-shaped. So that we can find this x-axis, we can go for this y-axis. This is the y-axis, and we can go for this z-axis. This is angle subtended here. And particularly, for this particular wedge-shaped, we can resolve the forces horizontally as well as vertically. Let small px is the intensity of horizontal pressure on the element of the liquid. Py, small py, is the intensity of vertical pressure on the element of the liquid. And pz, small pz, is the intensity of pressure on the diagonal side, diagonal of the right angle triangle element, and phi is the angle of the element of the liquid. Similarly, capital Px is the total pressure on the vertical side BA of the liquid. Capital Py is the total pressure on the vertical side AC of the liquid, and Pz, capital Pz, is the total pressure on the vertical side of BC of the liquid. Now we can calculate capital Px is nothing but small Px into BA, the side. Similarly, Py is the small Py into AC. Pz is small Pz into BC. As the element of the liquid is at rest, therefore sum of horizontal and vertical components of liquid must be equal to zero. That is, we have to resolve the forces horizontally as well as vertically. First of all, we'll resolve the forces horizontally. Pz sine theta is equal to Px. See here. Pz sine theta, this is a Pz, okay? Pz sine theta, this one. Px. Now Pz is Pz BC sine theta is equal to Px into BA, Pz into BA. As Pz is equal to Pz into BA, put this value. BC sine theta is equal to BA. Equate this. These terms are going to cancel. You will get Pz is equal to Px. I repeat once again. Resolving forces horizontally. Pz sin theta is equal to Px. Pz BC sin theta, because Pz is Pz into BC sin theta as it is. And Px is Px into BA. Put this value. Put the sin theta is equal to opposite to hypotenuse. Put these values, cancelling, you will get pz is equal to px. Similarly, resolving the forces vertically. Similarly, resolving these forces vertically, this pz cos theta is equal to py minus w, where w is the weight of the liquid element. Since the element is very small, neglecting its weight, we get pz cos theta is equal to py, or pz bc cos theta is equal to py into ac. But bc cos theta is equal to ac, that is from the geometry of the figure. Cancelling the sides, we will get pz is equal to py. So from equation number 4, this is the equation number 4, that is pz is equal to px and pz is equal to py, we can find px is equal to py is equal to pz. Hence, at any point in fluid at rest, the intensity of pressure is exerted equally in all directions, which is called as a Pascal's law. These are some of the applications of Pascal's law. We can apply a very small force over here. This force traveled over here and this particular car is lifted up. We often see this scenario in an automobile station. This is another application, that is hydraulic pump, hydraulic jug. This also one of the often seen application of Pascal law, when we apply force with this handle and this small jack will lift the vehicle. Similarly, for hydraulic brake also the same application, the same theory is used of Pascal's law. Now pause the video and answer these questions. The Pascal's law states that the liquid at rest applies pressure at a point is dash in all directions, and second one, the Pascal law is applicable to the liquid which is, there are options given, choose the correct option. Now see the answer. The Pascal's law states that the liquid at rest applies pressure at a point is same in all directions. Remaining three options are not correct. And in the second one, the Pascal law is applicable to the liquid which is incompressible. The other options are not correct. That is compressible, solid in phase, and super compressible, compressive. So these three are not correct. Incompressible is the correct option. Now, depending on this Pascal law, we'll solve one example. This is the example of the hydraulic press. See, the diameter of the ram and a plunger of an hydraulic press are 150 mm and 20 mm respectively. Find the weight lifted by the hydraulic press when the force applied at the plunger is 350 newtons. This is a hydraulic press. This is the ram. Over this ram, a weight is placed. This is a plunger. Through this plunger, a force is applied. F1 is the force applied. This force carried through this particular portion, and then this lifted up, this W here, that this is the weight of this particular box. It is lifted up, this F2 that we are going to, or we can say W that we are going to calculate. Whenever the problem is given to you, write down the data given. First, diameter of the plunger, d, small d, its area, calculate the area, diameter of the ram, then calculate the area of the ram as well as area of the plunger. It is 0.0176 meter square. That is the area of the ram. Area of the plunger, find out its areas. Then next step, that is to calculate intensity of pressure due to plunger. Now pressure we can calculate force upon area. Here force applied is of 350 newtons. Here force applied is 350 newtons. See here. Now here 350 newtons divided by area of the plunger. Area of the plunger. On this plunger the force is applied. So we will get 11146.49.6 newton per meter square. Always write the units. Units are very important. Always write the units. Since this is the intensity of pressure, this is going to transfer through this particular section. Now see here, since the intensity of pressure will be equally transmitted as per the Pascal law, the intensity of pressure at the ram is also same, but we can calculate the intensity of pressure as weight upon area. Weight is unknown. Put both the values and calculate weight. Weight is 19.61 kilonewton. Similar problems you can solve from these reference books. Thank you.